Hi there, so welcome to the video on how to use Zotero with Chromebook. First, I'll let you know, you're not going to be able to download the main program, which means you're going to be missing out on some of the features. And most importantly, you will not be able to add items to the group libraries, which you need to do for class, from that Chromebook. You will have to either add them manually, or you'll need to get on a computer that has Zotero installed so that you can quickly drag those things from your private library over to the group library. So just so you know ahead of time, there's no way that you can use Zotero fully on a Chromebook. But I'm going to show you some of the workarounds to get a lot of the work done, so that you'll at least be ahead of the curve once you get to the point where you need to add it to the group libraries. You'll be kind of ready to go. So you'll see here I've got Zotero.org. It's just Zotero.org. You'll see there's a download button, and then you'll see there's a login button. Okay, the first thing to do is set up your account. Just go to login and then go to register. And you do need to register with your western.edu email. That way you can connect to the group library for class. Okay, I'm already registered, so I'm just gonna log in real quick. Oop, apparently I don't know how to type. There we go. All right, and so this is kind of what it looks like once you get logged in. I am actually already added to the group library, but the next piece you would want to do is actually go to the inbox or your western.edu email and pull open the group invitation. And there's a link. And you just click the link and it will take you over to the group. I'm not sure what it's going to do right now. All right, it just took me to this page. You'll actually see a little join button here, and you are going to have to hit that join button in order to officially join the group. The group library is a library that everyone in class and your instructors can see, and you will be sharing your references through this method so everyone can see everything that's being researched. All right, the My Library section. This is your private library, okay? And this is where you can add items and organize them. Now, when you're in this Zotero Online on a Chromebook and you cannot download the program, you can only add items to this private library, and there's no way to move them over to the group library online. This is the point when you would have to actually get on a computer that has Zotero downloaded, maybe a friend's computer, and then sync your account into that downloaded program and drag everything over. When you're ready to do that, you can watch that video that I have made about dragging things over to the group library. It is in the adding items to Zotero video. But for now, I'll show you how to add items to your private library and organize those. And then from there, you can figure out the best method for you to get things into the group library. All right, so the first thing is we do want to go back over to the Zotero main page, because there is one component you can install. So you go into download. You can't do this piece, but this piece you can do because it's in the cloud. And it's going to default to whatever browser you're in. And it's just the connector. So you'll click on that. It'll pop up something like this. You'll say add the extension. And what it's going to do is put a little icon up in your browser that says save to Zotero. You might have to close your browser and reopen it in order for that to show up. Okay. But this will allow you to actually add things into the library, even online. So let's go ahead and practice that. Here's our library. The first thing I want to do is actually maybe add a folder for this. So I'm going to go create collection right over here. They call them collections in Zotero. And then you'll just name your collection. That's an odd little pop-up, isn't it? We'll just name it 605. And we'll create. So now we have a folder named 605. And this, you could save everything in here. You could make multiple folders to organize information, like if it goes to a different group or something like that in the group library. And so you have everything kind of ready to go that when you do get a hold of a computer with Zotero downloaded, you could easily, quickly transfer it over because it's already organized. So here we've got 605. One nice thing about Zotero is that if you're in the big library, it'll save things directly there. And if you have a folder selected, it will save things to that folder directly. They always go into the big library, but it'll organize it for you as you're adding items to Zotero. So now we're ready to go. I'm just going to go over to the library homepage. Actually, the first thing I want to do is go to a website. So I have epa.gov open here. Epa.gov has these news releases, and I have one open. And let's say I want to save this to my Zotero because I want to use it in my research. I'm just going to go up to this Save Zotero button, and I'm going to click that. Now, the very first time you do this and you don't have Zotero installed, it's going to say download Zotero, so you cancel and try again. You can't do that, so just do the enable saving to online library, and it will save it over to your online library. So I'm going to go back over there, and here's my thing. I'm going to have to do a little bit of a refresh, and unfortunately, it didn't save it to our folder. That's a feature that's in the downloaded version, and I guess it doesn't work online. Sorry, guys. But here it is. It's showing up in your library. And then if you want to move it, you can select that, and you would do right over here, not export. You want to move. Where's move? Add to collection. So you'd say add to collection, and then 605, and you would add it. And now it shows in 605. So a couple extra steps for you there, but it did add the item into Zotero. Now, if we click on this, you'll see the information that was saved. You may need to update this, and you can. If you go up to edit, it'll pop open the form, and then you can edit if anything was wrong. And maybe they didn't put in an author name, you would need to update the title because it is not in sentence case, and it should be for APA. Unfortunately, Zotero will not fix that, so you do have to fix that before you start making citations. So that's one thing. And then it'll just save when you've made your changes. There you go. I do recommend that when you are pulling things into Zotero that you immediately jump over and double check the information so you don't have to go and find it again later. It just saves time in the long run to just make sure everything's good as you go. All right, so now going back to the library homepage, if I wanted to search for an article, I just go to articles. I did a search for spruce beetle. Did a search, and I had this list come up here. Okay. Now I want to add some of these. The rule in Zotero is to get to the information page. So I'm going to click on one of these here, and here's my information page. And again, I'm just going to click on that little button up there, and it's going to pop up and say it's saving to Zotero. And I'll go back to my Zotero. I'll do a little refresh. Again, I need to look at my library, and then there it is, okay? And again, I'll click on it, I'll double check the information, okay? And we can do the same thing with books. So again, in the Savage Library homepage, go to Books and Media. I did a search for beetles, and then this is my result list. Looks a little crazy because we've got these bento boxes going on, but the from the catalog chunk, this is stuff that we own. So we can do full results from the catalog to see the whole list. And then this first one is a book, so we'll click on it. We're at the information page. We'll pull it in. There you go. You can go back over, refresh, and there it is. All right. Now ebooks are a little different, so let me go on back over. This one is an ebook. All right, now if you save from here, and I'm gonna go ahead and do that, this is the information page, right? And that's what I keep saying is where you wanna be. We're gonna add that, go back over, refresh, and is it the conservation one? Yes, so it's this one here, and if you look at the information, it just says web page, and it doesn't really have much information. It's not correct, it's not a web page, it's a book. And this is what happens with ebooks. So we're gonna go back over, and we're gonna try again, okay? And this time I'm gonna go to access online. So I'm gonna actually jump into the database where the ebook lives, and here's another information page. Now I'm gonna go up and add it. All right, and we'll head back over, and I'll go back to the library list, and here's the new one. And now it says book and it has stuff entered. So you will have to occasionally click into an ebook, and every now and then you might even have to click like read online and open up the ebook. That isn't common, but sometimes you have to do that. So just double check when you pull it in to make sure that it has pulled in the information you want. All right, so that's how you can use the connector, and that might speed up the process a little bit for you. I'm gonna go back to my library. But you can also add things manually. So they have this little create item, green plus sign. You just click on that and say what kind of, it's a journal article, okay? And we'll continue, and it's gonna give you the form to fill out, okay? So a little bit tedious, but you certainly can add items that way. For the case of this online, when you can't use the Zotero, that's pretty much what you're limited to in using Zotero. When you want to go create your bibliography, you can select all these items and or the ones that you want, and then you can go over here where it says cite, and it's going to pop up a little box. You'll say select style, APA, and here you go. And then you just paste these, you select and paste these into a Word document. Now, if you can get a hold of a computer that can download Zotero, watch those other videos and get that set up, because there's so many more features that you could use that could speed up your process for you. Unfortunately, Chromebooks just don't work well with Zotero. But you can do this much. So I hope this was helpful. And let me know if you have any problems when you're doing this. Just shoot me an email. All right. Thanks. Bye-bye.